A patient dies while waiting in a hospital emergency room, and a worker tells us the patient was dead for hours before anyone even noticed. How could this happen? It's an exclusive story you will see only here on Eyewitness News. And good evening again at 5:30. I'm Diana Williams.
And I'm Sade Bederedwala. A worker at St. Barnabas Hospital in the Bronx was so upset with what happened, he came to Eyewitness News.
We actually first broke this story on 7 Online today, and we shared it on Facebook and Twitter. The investigator's Jim Hoffer here right now with exclusive details. Jim?
Well, let's start off by saying that St. Barnabas is a good hospital. The doctors and nurses there save lives every day. But earlier this week, an overburdened emergency room may have failed in its mission to help the sick. A man died at some point during a more than 8-hour wait for care. Most alarming, he may have been dead for several hours before anyone noticed. The patient, a 30-year-old man, walked into St. Barnabas Hospital's emergency room Sunday night around 10 o'clock, complaining about a rash. His vitals were taken, and he was told to sit in a packed waiting room until his name was called. At 6 a.m. the next morning, he was found by a security guard, dead in a waiting room chair.
They found this person slumped over, cold, blue, and stiff.
How long was he dead?
We're assuming 2 to 4 hours.
How can that be at a major hospital in New York City?
There's no policy in place to check the waiting room to see if people who are waiting to be seen are still there or are still alive.
This emergency room employee who requested anonymity for fear of retaliation was working that night. He says there's one reason the patient died and was dead for several hours just feet from doctors and nurses.
I'm saying that he died because there's not enough staff to take care of the number of patients that we see per day.
The hospital claims the patient, John Verrier, was checked several times during those 8 hours and his name called when doctors were ready to see him. It says he was checked on and his name was called several times.
He was not checked on, so that's 100% false. Was his name called? Yes, it was, 3 times. Right over the PA system is impossible to check on each person physically.
A hospital spokesman says that per our policy and procedures, security checked on the patient and others. Video surveillance confirms that he was still active and moving around as late as 3:45 a.m. An internal review, the spokesman goes on to say, has concluded that all hospital guidelines were met.
For me, it feels like a cover-up.
The ER worker says if the hospital fails to face up to its mistakes, they will happen again.
I understand that it's a business, but if people are dying under your watch, something needs to be done.
We don't know how many hours this young man sat dead in a waiting room chair, but the fact is he went to St. Barnabas at 10 p.m. More than 8.5 hours later, a security guard found him unresponsive. Any health professional would probably conclude that's a procedural breakdown that needs immediate fixing. We should also note the medical examiner has yet to determine a cause of death. This story came to us through a whistleblower. If you have an issue you need investigated, please contact us at 877-TIP-NEWS or email the.investigators@abc.com.